The supraspinatus and infraspinatus tendons consist of 5 histological layers, though not all of these layers are clearly visible on MRI. These layers are best evaluated using oblique coronal and sagittal MRI, and understanding their anatomy is critical for accurate interpretation. Among these layers, layer 2 and layer 3 are particularly significant, while layer 1 and layer 4 are associated with the coracohumeral ligament, and layer 5 corresponds to the joint capsule. Coronal images. On oblique coronal fat-suppressed T2-weighted images, the basal surface, layer 2, and articular surface, layer 3, appear as low-signal intensity layers. Between them, an intermediate signal intensity region is seen, which should not be misinterpreted as tendinosis or an interstitial partial thickness tear. Layer 2, basal fibers. This is a thicker layer, 3 to 5 mm, composed of parallel-oriented tendon fibers. Layer 3, deep fibers. This is a thinner layer, approximately 3 mm, with fibers crossing at 45-degree angles, lacking uniform orientation. This layer also demonstrates low signal intensity, which can sometimes mimic the appearance of calcification in calcific tendinitis. Interstitial or intrasubstance tears typically occur between layer 2 and layer 3. The rotator cable can sometimes be visualized as a low signal intensity band on coronal images. It is located near the articular surface, running perpendicular to the long axis of the supraspinatus and infraspinatus tendons. The thickness of the rotator cable can vary, and it may not always be conspicuous in every case. It is essential to distinguish this structure from retracted tendon fibers to avoid diagnostic errors. On this MRI, the rotator cable is more clearly visible. Sagittal images. The coracohumeral ligament has 2 extensions, which are best visualized on sagittal images. Layer 1, superficial limb. This courses along the basal surface. Layer 4, deep limb. This corresponds to the rotator cable and runs along the articular surface. I'll discuss the rotator cable in more detail next time. And don't mistake layer 1 for the adjacent coracoacromial ligament.